Thank you for the kind introduction. I may be coming from the simple family, but I have the most complicated wife. I have not been able to figure out the last 50 years, and I don't think I can do it for another 50 years. But I have asked to God for Saat Janmo Tak. Then I have enough time. Thanks, anyway. Dear honorable guest, Dr. Mantar, Chairman of All India Council Education Government of India. Thank you for making time for us today. I know it's long. We are a long way from New Delhi. But the way we are going, in few years, our back end would reach to the Delhi, then you won't have to travel. Sri Anil Bhai, thank you for the kind words. You are one of a kind friend. Lakshman Bhai, you are doing a wonderful job. Thank you. Keep up with the good work. Just a few years ago, when we were doing a Bhumi Pujan here, this was a bare land. There was only Banchiyas here, and I had asked P.I. Patel to take an account of the Banchiyas. This is a true story. During the Bhumi Pujan, during my speech, I asked P.I. Patel to take an account of how many Banchiyas we have, so we can produce that many graduates. Looks like we are about to outdo the Banchiyas. Good job. Before we celebrate class of 2013, let's recognize some of the people who have contributed to your success or you being here. First and foremost, your family, your parents, who have spent sleepless nights. They have sent you money. They never gave you any excuses. I cannot afford it. They have probably stayed up worrying about you, thinking about you. And the best part is they have written their last check. Now it is your turn to thank them and reciprocate for what they have done to you. So let's thank them. Let's get up, please, 2013 class. Give a big hand to the parents. Let's also, while we are up, let's also give a big hand to the trustee board, the donors, for building the fine institution. We have many people have contributed to this institution, but when I walk through this campus, there are two people who I see everywhere. One of them is my late brother Moti Dada. Every tree today, when I see, I remember Moti Dada. The other person is Anand. Anand, please, can you? Are you here? Anand is not here. Anand is, as you know, Anil Bhai's son. He is the most dedicated young man here on campus. And he's always worried and thinking about how to move forward with this campus. Thank you, Anil Bhai and Sharda Bhai. Especially Sharda Bhai, thank you for giving us a nice son and raising a fine husband. It's easy to raise child, but it's not easy to raise husband. You can ask my wife. She'll tell you. So few days ago, now you may sit down, please. Thank you. A couple days ago, when I came, I ran into somebody, and he said, Sarpat Bhai, you have done a good job. Tamne bahut saras kaam karyu. Ame ahi aga atla bada graduate thavana chhe. So he was trying to be nice to me. I said, good, good, good. But tamara wife pan bahut saras chhe. She, bahu amke bhavik chhe. Amne તમે હોશિયાર છો કે તમે આવા વાઇફ ગોતી કાઢ્યા. મેં કીધું, ભાઈ મારે આ લાઈનમાં ટ્રાયો લાગી ગયો છે. હું 18 વર્ષનો હતો, મારા હસબન્ડ મારા ફાધરે મારા લગ્ન કરાવી દીધા હતા, એટલે લાઈનમાં ટ્રાયો લાગી ગયો ને. આઈ એમ સો હેપી ધેટ આઈ હેવ અ ટ્રાયો. થેન્ક યુ મંજુબેન ફોર હેલ્પિંગ મી આઉટ ફોર ધીસ ગુડ કોઝ. Let us also thank our professors and faculty. They have given part of their life to make your life. They have been so kind to you. Teaching profession is not monetarily very rewarding, but they do it because they love it. One of your professors maybe have been tough on you time to time, but it was only for your good. So whenever in the future you see your professor, please bow down to them, give them your respect. You will have a great feeling, and you will bring tears to their eyes also. I know I always did my past professors, and they had loved it. I loved it. They're a special type of people. Few days ago, I got an email from several professors from here that one of our young men have gotten into Microsoft with a handsome package, salaries and all that. Today, I also heard that somebody also got a job at Google. Well, it could happen to any one of you also. So, keep your eyes open, ears open, and go forward. And I have met many, many past graduates from this institution. They are working for some of the best and the biggest companies, Amazon.com, Microsoft, Google, IBM. So your future is secure. I think this institute is putting out the best graduates. They can stack up with anybody, anywhere, anytime. So I want to congratulate class of 2013. I also want you to know that you are my joy and you are my pride. But more than that, being a Gujarati businessman who loves profit more than anything else, you are my biggest profit. There has been no better investment in my life than this institution. And I expect your life not to be any different than mine. Hope that someday you can do something for the community as well. Today I want to share a very important lesson that I learned in my life many years ago. I left India when I was only 19 years old. I was married. I had a pregnant wife. I was barely shaving. My mom was crying. Many people in my family thought I was too crazy to go to America at that age. But I was thinking totally different. In my mind, I thought I had nothing to lose. How could I lose? I had nothing. I had nothing but to gain. So, I used to see some of the foreign returns, some of the people coming back from America, and look at them, and they were so polished, and they were so knowledgeable about everything. I immediately decided I want to be one of those. And so I am going to go no matter what. There was an India-Pakistan war going on. I remember that day, I was in the train, and the train had turned off all the lights on here to Bombay. And we barely made to Bombay, and our plane, when they took off, there was also no lights at the airport. Future was pretty cloudy. So as you graduate, you probably feel the same way. But it's quite normal. Things look hazy, but when you travel a little bit more, then you see a little bit more, and you go a little bit further, and you see a little bit more, and life goes on. And it keeps becoming clearer and clearer and clearer. So if you can't see a long distance today, don't worry. Keep moving. Make a little bit of progress every day. And it will be all clear as you move. I want to share a personal experience with one of my granddaughters. I have been blessed by Saraswati in my family. All my children and grandchildren seem to be highly educated. I am lucky. Thanks to my wife again. It's not funny because starting tomorrow I am going to have to eat her cooking. Tonight dinner is on you, I know. So last year, my oldest granddaughter graduated from MIT. She's got a master's degree in computer science and engineering. And she was offered a job by Google, one of the finest companies in the world. And her workplace was about 500 miles away. So I decided to drive her, to drop her off. We had 8 hours in the car, one-on-one. She's pretty introvert. She does not talk too much. You can ask a lot of questions, then she will say yes or no. So I was talking to her. Her name is Amy. I said, Amy, beta, tell me. What did you learn at MIT? How is MIT different than any other school? She said, Dada, MIT is not any different. I'm not any different. We're all same. We're people. I said, No. Before you graduated from MIT, Google came to you, every single company, every single biggest, nicest company came to you and offered you a job. there is something special about you. There is something about special about people who get into places like MIT. And it's even more special if you get out of that place. She said, Dada, there is nothing special about me. I said, no, there is special. She said, okay, I tell you what. When Google was interviewing me, Google never asked any question that what I had learned at MIT. Not a single question about physics, math, or anything else, or computer science. They just asked simple question, and they look at my reaction and my answer, see if I'm thinking out of the box. You know what is thinking out of the box is? Something that nobody has ever done it before. Not the normal way of doing things, not as usual. I said, I got my answer. I'm going to pass that on to my graduating class of 2013. Think out of the box. The days that we used to do as usual are behind us. The Google, the Twitter, the Facebook, all of these companies are the results of thinking out of the box. Basically, when I left India at the age of 19, that was also out of the box. Because in those days, if you're 19, you are not graduate yet, you are married, your wife is pregnant, you don't do silly things like leaving India and go for a higher study to America. But I did, and it paid off. So do crazy things. Do things that are not normal. It's okay. Matter of fact, it's more than okay. It is the only way to do it. We must change. It Gujarati joke kahu ek bhai hata ene lokhandi pipe hati emne joye ane kutra ni puchli lokhandi pipe ma gali ane pachi baitha tha am to maharaj ji ko ye puchu ke tame aa shu karo cho ke kutra ni puchli to tame 100 vare sudhi besi rahecho to e vaaki nahi thai. તો કે બુદ્ધું મારે કૂતરાની પૂંછડી સુધી નથી કરવી, મારે તો પાઇપ પાકી કરવી છે. સો ડોન્ટ બી લાઈક કૂતરાની પૂંછડી. ચેન્જ ધ પાઇપ. સો વોટ ડુ વી કોલ ધીસ ગ્રેજ્યુએશન એન્ડ સેરેમોની? It's an exercise. Graduation is not the end. It is just the beginning. You will be learning every day. You will be graduating every day. Wait till you get married, if you are not. You will learn a lot more, a lot faster. And that is going to be another process yet. So keep learning. Learning process should not end until the last day of your life. I want to congratulate all the gold medalists, but I also want to congratulate the one who was not so lucky that did not get the gold medal. I want to congratulate you too. You have more incentive to work harder. So, look at this way. Thank God that I did not get a gold medal. Now I can work harder. This is not the end of the world. There are 7 billion people in this world. But each one of you is a unique. Your fingertips are unique. There is nobody else exactly like you. God, when God created you, He made absolutely sure that you were unique. There was never, nobody was ever created like you, and there will never be one like you. So you are a masterpiece. So God has created you masterpiece. So you must act like a masterpiece. You must be original. Do not try to copy anybody. Be yourself. Be proud of what you are. Because you are a masterpiece. You don't need to copy. You are not a copy. You are not a Xerox copy. You are the original. Many people, you know, they try to copy Shah Rukh Khan and Salman Khan and Katrina and Kareena. And you don't need to do that. They go to parlor and they go to doctor and they're trying to change their hairstyle and they are not happy with themselves. They are constantly trying to change. Why do you want to be them? They don't want to be them. Why do you want to be them? Be yourself. Be proud of yourself. Create the brand new ways of doing things. Travel on the brand new road. Because you are the only one of a kind, you can do find one of a kind road. One more piece of advice that I want to give you today. As you move in your life, please do some philanthropic work. Whenever you get the opportunity, it will be gratifying. Someone had said once, the true meaning of life is planting a tree whose shade you do not expect to sit under. Your life will be one thing at this age, at 22. You will have a different meaning of life at 32. And different again at 42 and 52 and so on. So your outlook in life will change. But what you do today is going to have an impact on what you're going to be in the future. So do something good today and you will have a reward in the future. In life, you will truly serve what you love. If you love your country, you're going to serve your country. If you love your community, you're going to serve the community. If you love money, you will serve money and you will have lots of it. If you love your family, you're going to serve your family. But if you love yourself only, then you will serve yourself only. This is pretty selfish. And there is no winning there. So my advice is to love others, serve others, and hopefully, in return, they will do the same to you. And life will have some meaning. You will be living a meaningful life. The service is a love made visible. Do not be afraid of failures. If you live entire life without make any mistake at all, you have lived your life so carefully that you have not accomplished much, that life is not worth living. You might have you might as well have not lived. So by default, you are failure. So go on and take a risk. You are going to fall down every now and then. I have. But as long as you have got up one more time than you have fallen down, the world will not remember how many times you have fallen down. I have many failures, but nobody here thinks that I am a failure. My wife knows that. She could tell you. She reminds me all the time. Nattiketti? The great manager of our time, Ratan Tata, he has a special award in his company every year. This award is for the best failed idea. Idea that was the biggest failure of the year. Do you know why he would give an award to the failures? Because he knows that success is the basis of failure. If you haven't failed, you are probably not going to be successful. So get that fear of failure out of you. There is no such thing as failure. Call it a learning process. The other thing is, you must control your destiny. All days are not going to be same. Some days are cloudy and some days are raining. But it is up to you to make a good day. Be prepared to give 100% to yourself. One more thing. In today's world, do not ignore the cutting edge technology. Today, with iPhone and iPad, you have entire world in your palm. Many years ago, we used to have to go to library. Libraries were not big enough. There was not everything available. Today, you don't need to do that. You have all you need in your hand. So learn how to use it and use it effectively. So, as we say goodbye to you from this campus, I want to wish you three things. One is, I want to wish you get a trial in your life like I did. Secondly, I want to wish you and your family good health. Thirdly, I want to wish you and your family a good financial success. Enough money to live happy life, but not so much that money brings you misery. Lakshmi, when Lakshmi comes, she also comes with whole bunch of battalions with her. She does bring bunch of vices. I do not want to wish that for you. I want Lakshmi to come during the daytime, not on the goad. One last thing, and the most important thing I want to wish for you, is your mental happiness. The mental happiness is you are happy with your life. Today, wherever I go, I get compliments, and that makes me happy. And this is what my wish for you as you leave this campus. Lately, during my retirement, I've been watching my children and grandchildren given authority and opportunity. I have no doubt that they can run with the torch, and I know you will also. In closing, remember, the future of any country lies with the youth, that is you. So learn hard, work hard, so that India and your parents be proud of you. Thank you and good luck to each and every one of you. May God bless you. Thank you.